don't. I was gonna say, like, why not CNN or, but well, who cares? White Truth, right? Is it about a future movie or something coming out or?
No.
Okay.
It's not about any movie. It's not about the movies I've made in the past. It's a confession of sorts.
Okay. I mean, about you cheated on your wife,
No.
you
No, I would
plagiarized.
never do that.
You
No.
plagiarize
It's
something.
about a movie I made that nobody is aware of, even though they've seen it. Is that
Okay.
intriguing? Do I have you intrigued?
Well, I mean, see if I understand what you said. It's about a movie you made, no one knows you made. Is that what you said?
That's right. It's a production
Like,
that I
some of you put, like,
supervised.
you didn't put your name on, like, at the end, you put, like, a fake name.
Oh no, I made it.
Like Alan Smithy, like that
That's
type of
right.
thing.
No, I didn't. There was no name put on it.
Why? Why would there be no credits? We mean.
Because there are some things that you just can't put your name on.
Okay. What?
I perpetrated a huge fraud, which I am now about to detail,
Okay.
involving the United States government and NASA.
All right.
And I'm sure you've heard the rumors.
The moon landing
That's
hoax?
right, that the moon landing was fake. The moon landings all were fake. And I was the person who filmed it.
You're serious and okay.
I'm serious, I'm dead serious.
Because I only have this certain amount of time with you, and I'll talk about whatever you want. You're not, this isn't some type of joke or
No, it's not a
film
joke.
within a film
It's
thing.
not a
If,
joke. Nope.
okay.
The conspiracy theorists were right on this occasion.
Why?
I don't know about Paul McCartney's death, but this they were right about.
Okay. Why in God's name would, I don't know what to ask you first. Why the hell, if you're telling the truth, why would you do it? Why are you telling me? I mean, what
Don't
the?
you think it's important for people to know the truth?
Yeah, I got, yes,
They had
certainly.
a massive fraud, an unparalleled fraud perpetrated against them. They should know.
Okay.
I mean, they're already suspicious of the government. They may as well have their suspicions confirmed
Okay.
and
Well.
justified.
And this, why now? I mean, we're almost at the 30-year anniversary. What took so long? Why are you, why, if this is true,
I won't
why?
go into that. It has to do with personal
Okay.
evolution and influences.
And
I'll
well,
go into
is
that.
that why you look a little haggard right now? Because you look a little worn, no offense, like.
Well, also, yeah, because I haven't been taking care of myself too well. I've been drinking a lot, but
Is that because of the stress of this?
of course, stress, guilt, just conflict of all kinds.
Wow. I mean, so you feel bad about this, clearly. I mean, this is
I
not.
do feel bad about it. I also feel proud of it. It's a terrible conflict.
Because you've pulled off one of the greatest hoaxes ever because of
And
your.
because I made a film, if you want to call it a film, which I consider to be my masterpiece.
And you can't take credit or even talk about it as a
Well, I'm
well, you
hereby
are
taking
now,
credit for it.
right? But you can't actually go out. You're doing it. When people see
But
this,
no one's
you'll
going
be
to see this
dead,
until 10 years or
right? Or
15 years,
15,
actually,
yeah.
after my death.
So you can't talk to Roger Ebert about it, you know? Does that frustrate you?
I have to pay the consequences for the decision that I made many years ago to go along with this.
Like a deal with the devil.
It's Faustian, to be sure.
Because, and is that why you got such power in Hollywood? I mean, that would explain that.
Why I have the freedom I have, that was part of it, yes.
So they said, do this moon thing and we'll give
When I
you.
made Spartacus, I didn't have this kind of freedom.
Right.
But I have it now.
So what came
And
first, the genius or the
it was
fraud?
NASA's doing.
Well, what came first, the genius or the fraud? I mean, did the fraud enable the genius, or was the genius
Well, I'd
released by the
like to think the
fraud?
genius came first.
Right.
But some frauds are hard to bypass, especially if you have an ego and you're an artist and you you're presented with a challenge, the likes of which you've never seen and will probably never see again. You don't even think of the morality of it. You're just completely swept away by the flattery of it and the juices inside you, which make you want to do it as the artist you are innately. You don't think of anything else.
What a conflict. I mean, gosh, I can't imagine being presented with that opportunity. On one hand, I really would want to do it, but then I'd probably say, well, I'm committing a crime and lying. And
it depends, but my guess would be, no, you if you're good, you would do it. I discussed this with Levinson, Barry Levinson.
Right.
I discussed it with...
Oh, he made Wag the Dog, right? Yeah.
Yes. Spielberg, of all people, believe it or not, yes.
So wait, Wag the Dog?
Coppola, Scorsese, even Woody Allen, I discussed. There isn't one of them who wouldn't do this.
Right. And did that, so Barry Levinson must have been influenced by this whole, he must have known, so that's, Wag the Dog is about this whole idea. I mean, that's why...
The character was named Stanley.
Right, and he gets killed at the end because he demands credit. So tell me about the making of it. So, was it difficult? I mean, committing the greatest fraud, what you want to call it. I'm not saying it's a...
Okay. I know a lot about that at the time.
I know, so I'm not making moral judgment, but making this huge, ambitious, technical faux landing, was it harder than 2001? Was it very difficult? I mean, what was the experience like? Artistically, practically, emotionally, what was
Nothing
it like?
Nothing was harder than 2001.
So 2001 was harder than faking the moon landing?
It actually was.
Because you learned things on 2001 and...
Yes. I mean, 2001 was very ambitious. And that's not to say that faking the moon landing was not ambitious. But, yeah, I learned things making 2001, which is why I got this gig in the first place, right?
Right. Right, that makes sense. So, so what was the
But it was easy for me because, well, first of all, I didn't think a whole lot about the morality of it, as I said. If I had, I might have been more hesitant, more stifled in my work, but I didn't. And I could see that Neil was, actually. He was bothered by it.
More than Buzz Aldrin or anyone else involved?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
About
in
what?
A way, everything was going to center around him. He was the one who was supposed to come down off the ladder and announce the step for mankind and what have you. He sensed that this was going to be a life-changing experience for him, and I mean on a major scale. Actually, he was rather tortured by it the rest of his life.
Really? I mean, is that why you think of interviews?
Yes, and in fact, that actually began to affect my own perception of it, watching what happened to him.
Okay, in what way? Just seeing the deterioration of him? And I mean, was he depressed? Or?
He was depressed. He was drinking heavily, bitter, scared, just... phobic, avoiding people.
And that guy Bart Sibrel or something tried to get him to swear in a Bible.
When I say he affected me, that's why there was so much time in between films for me. Between Full Metal Jacket and, well, between The Shining and Full Metal Jacket was about 6 years. Between Full Metal Jacket and Eyes Wide Shut is 13 years.
Yeah.
And a lot of that time was spent just...
like just emotionally processing?
Yes. It became very conflicting for me. I was proud of my work, but at the same time... and this was a lot because of Neil's influence. Not consciously. He didn't do this to me consciously. But I spent a lot of time with him, and each time I did, I became more and more... bothered, troubled by my own participation in this.
Okay. Well, what would he say? I mean, did he explain the source of his depression?
He was on the verge of tears. He did not cry. I won't say he cried, but he was on the verge of tears so many times because of what he did.
I mean...
what he participated in. It's almost as if he thought up the idea, you know?
Right. He felt that guilt.
He was almost used, really.
Okay.
But he's the one who felt the guilt. I'm sure NASA did not feel that much guilt.
I mean, why did he go up, I wonder? I wonder why. Because they promised him a seat in 3 years when they figured it out. They kept lying about it being possible. So why do you think he did it? Why did Armstrong do it in the first place? He thought, they kept saying, we'll be ready in 3 years and you'll go then. Just lie now and we'll go in 3 years. The funding will keep going and we'll figure this out and you'll go.
Oh, actually go.
Right,
okay,
yeah.
Okay.
And they, but they were lying, you know, yeah. And they figured it out. And he got really, you know, so cynical. Got it?
Okay.
So why did Armstrong go? I mean, he was such a moral, principled man. Why would he go on a fake moon mission? I don't believe that.
Well, they strung him along because they led him to believe, oh, don't worry, we're going to have the money in a few years, and we'll actually go, and then you will go.
They'll have, course, you mean they'll have the technology in a few years?
Yes.
Okay.
They will have enough, they will, yes, they will be able to actually perform a miracle of going to the moon. And yes, he would be in the saddle.
So otherwise, okay, let's make this clear. Kennedy set a deadline, psychological deadline of the 60s. They knew they couldn't beat it.
Right. But they would be great PR if they did.
Right. And if they did, you're saying they sincerely thought that they would really get there within a few years.
I believe, yes, they did think so.
Because that's what they, well, I mean, that's...
Although some didn't. There was a difference of opinion. There were some that just believed honestly that we will never be able to get there. There's just no chance.
That Werner and I used to, like, have coffee in the mornings, and he was like, that, you know, there's no fucking way, like,
right.
Is it, like, you know, Werner von Braun.
Right.
So go, you want that. Some people didn't believe that you could go even?
Well, Werner von Braun, of course, didn't.
The director didn't think so.
The man was just too brilliant. He knew that we couldn't do it.
Yeah. So, okay, I'm talking about a guy working on two lost causes, the Nazism and you know, the quest for the moon. I mean, he really, and he didn't tell them? I mean, did he ever tell them, did he tell NASA, like, did he tell the president we can't go? I mean, he must have been broke the news.
He was very old, of course, at the time, and a lot of people just dismissed him. Younger, more ambitious people, some of them really thought we could get there,
right?
Or wanted to believe it. Maybe on a conscious level, they knew we couldn't, but they just wanted to believe the impossible because they were so full of themselves.
And so full of the dream.
Yes, the dream was very powerful.
And that's what beguiled Armstrong. Here is a noble, stand-up guy, and he didn't want to be part of the lie, but he knew he'd get a seat if he played ball on when they actually did go up.
He was too good for this.
But that day never came, obviously.
That day never came.
And what did that do to him? I mean...
It gradually destroyed him, I think.
Okay.
He deteriorated. Yeah, like I said, he drank a lot. He was full of self-recrimination, and so was I. Well, mainly from his influence. I caught it.
Okay.
From him.
And now tell a story about, I talked to him one last time before his death, and he made me promise to get this news out. It was too great. It was, you know, this,
yeah,
one last story.
I died before him.
Okay. One last conversation that. Right, the last conversation you had was about 3 months ago, and he said that, you know, he's going to write a letter and put it in a drawer, and maybe his wife someday will give it out. But he's like, or Stanley, you know, you're a media guy, you got to tell the truth one day, you know, right before. But he urged me to tell the truth. You know, he knew he couldn't because of reasons that because he was a government employee his whole life and he had a government pension, and here I am, a millionaire, like, you know, you can afford to, Stanley, tell the truth. You know, I still get a government pension, you know what I'm saying? And that's been eating on you to do this. And that's why you're not doing it now, you're doing it 15 years from now, yeah, or whenever. Like, in other words, you're telling this, that's why you're not announcing on CNN. It's because you're gonna honor his wish, but you're not ready for it now to come out. But this is, you're doing this
why
for me.
Why am I putting it off? Because I think I'll be.
Because you don't want your family, you want to be dead.
Right.
And you don't want your family to have 15 years on it. Your wife will probably be dead and your kid will be grown.
Right.
You want distance from your legacy, from this truth. That's it.
Okay. Right.
So what happened? What really motivated contacting me as a filmmaker was I talked to Neil. And I really felt guilty, and that's why I arranged for you to interview me, because I wanted to blah, 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 blah. Let's talk about the motive. So Neil really got to you. I mean, it sounds like he's the impetus of this entire confession in a way. I mean, it's like a theme. Like, so he really
Yes,
did made
he
you
influenced me.
become circumspect about this.
He even virtually begged me to reveal all this. He couldn't do it himself. He has a pension to worry about. I had basically nothing to lose. I'm, an established filmmaker, not involved with the government in any way except for this one job. And I made my millions. I'm really basically set for life. I'm almost 70.
But you still must fear one thing they can do to you, which is, I mean, I don't know, do you ever, I mean, you obviously, do you ever worry about them killing you because of the secret? I mean, you have become a bit of a recluse. I don't know, with the.
Yeah, Garbo, Howard Hughes, J.D. Salinger, and me.
Right.
And to some degree, Neil.
But did they, I mean, did any of them think that the government was out to get them? And I'm not saying you think that, do you? I mean, the government
Maybe
obviously
Howard
said they'll
Hughes,
kill
but.
you. I mean, obviously, the government said we'll kill you if you say anything. I mean, that's a standard top secret sort of penalty
It's
for them.
understood, even if it's not said.
Right. But they did say it to you, I presume. They did. I mean, the
Yes, they
government,
did. Yes, they
they
did.
said basically, so it
They tried
wasn't.
to be cute about it, but yeah, it was said in no uncertain terms.
So why are you, so this won't, this can't this get you killed?
Well, that's why I'm delaying it.
Okay, the 15 years
This is
thing.
not going to be seen
Okay,
for
until
another
15 years after you're
15
dead.
years.
Well, no, that's if you die tomorrow. You're not gonna die tomorrow, clearly.
I'm sorry.
Okay, try again, try again. Yeah, it's okay.
This
So why
could.
you could get killed by doing this? This could kill you. Why are you doing that? That's.
Well, this is not going to be seen until
Oh, because of our
15
fish.
years after my
So now
death.
that's why you have to sign the NDA and all these. Okay.
That's right.
All right. Well, that makes sense now. Okay, I understand that
Yes.
now. All
It
right.
should be known, but I want there to be some kind of cushion for my family. 15 years seems like a good number.
Okay. All right.
After my death, 15 years after my death.
But okay, so let's take a step back. You're making this tape out of an effect Neil had on you? I mean, Armstrong sort of
Very
influenced you?
much. Sometimes it just takes a catalyst. I mean, somewhere inside you know what's right.
Right.
I mean, I went for years just thinking I was doing the right thing, just through my art. And then something comes along that you don't even recognize as a temptation because you're so swept away by your own ego. It took someone like Neil Armstrong and distance and time to hammer into me what this really meant about society, about myself, about the human condition even, which is what I'm about.
So you must
And
feel very
yes,
proud and very guilty and proud of this thing. I mean, it's.
conflicted. I mean, I still think it's a terrible, maybe it's a terrible thing to say, maybe not, but I look at that or even think of it. I just remember it. And I think this was my fucking masterpiece.
Yeah,
I still think so.
right. I mean, it's the greatest
Despite its
mystery.
flaws, it's my goddamn masterpiece. It's better than 2001. It's better than Paths of Glory or Clockwork Orange or Barry Lyndon or Doctor Strangelove, all of which I love, but this is better.
And you're include now that's the moon landing itself, and that's and what a triumphal story that is. Were you involved in any of the other missions at all, or is that just the one? I mean, would they just take your thing, or was it a one-off, or did you do them all? I mean, you just did 11 and 13. They brought you back after 12 failed. Okay, just to do 13. That's it. And Neil helped you with that. So was it just a one-off? I mean, you just did them. Did you do them
Well,
all,
I
or
did 11 and 13 as well,
you did 13? Okay.
not 12.
Why is 13
They
a failure then? Why did you?
brought me back
And why? But why did
after
you
12 failed.
make it? 12 failed. How? What do you mean? How did
What
12
do you
fail?
tell me till 12 failed?
How did it? I'm asking you in
I don't know.
character. How did 12 fail?
Sam, can we stop for a
Nobody
second?
watched it. No one cared.
Oh, okay, yeah. Okay. I'm sorry.
Okay, so you did 11 and 13, but why 13? Why'd you make 13 into like a failure? Why did you?
Because 12 was a disaster. I
What
mean,
do you mean?
nobody cared
Why?
anymore.
They
72, by
oh.
then it was old hat almost. People just didn't care. And that's why they had to play golf up there.
Okay,
I
so
mean, as if golf was the, was watchable. I mean, if they'd had a horse race, that would have been watchable.
That's true.
But a golf match, I mean, a golf game on the moon,
Right. Okay, so they weren't getting the ratings,
that
essentially.
wasn't my idea. I will not take credit for that.
Okay, so it was really a ratings issue that if they 12 didn't pull the ratings that 11 did. And so why did you come up with 13 storyline? Like, how'd that happen? Like, the